What's up, boo?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all right. Another shady mission. Tricks. Like watching pictures in hazy vision. Tonight is love making. Take you any place you wish. Today we satisfy. Yesterday was stolen kisses. Blind insanity. Perfect pictures of me and my family. Not understanding the destiny that they plan for me. If I have kids, will I let her see them grow? Though I don't know, I live a life of a thug. Till the day I go, no broken promises. A sacred bond broken. I know I die alone, but yet and still I'm hoping. Visits of prisons, maybe I'll be forgiven. Now I know it's better in heaven, cause being here ain't living. Close my eyes and see nothing but pain. The world's crazy still, looking for a queen to plant seeds and have babies. Maybe I'll be the one, or just maybe I'm lost. You'll never know, being cautious. If you play your cards right,
I wanna be the one who you can depend on.
Play your cards right.
Take
your time.
Be the one.
Be patient.
I'll be the one. Don't rush. We will be there till the morning. We won't leave until
down.
The night. And we will be forevermore. No one else can do what you do for me. Take me away from the pain I feel.
Like it's a race, know what I'm saying?
No, no, no.
If you be patient, and you take
be
your time,
patient, baby.
And you finesse it. 9 times out of 10, homeboy, you're gonna wake up with your breakfast in bed. But if you rush, and you just be manhandling,
it takes some
play some fashion, light a fire. You got to be cool with it. You got to be slow with it. You got to be patient. Got to play your chords right on one. Can't be rushing like it's a race, know what I'm saying?
No way.
You be patient, and you take your time, and you finesse it.
Watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and count up. And count up.
Gave me something I don't really feel. But What you knew that already? When I found you on the ground, you was drowning. Now you come into my yard, uninvited. Can you see me on the edge? I'm a nod. If the world was ending, would you cry or would you try to get me? Tell me now, I want you to be clear. Tell me now, I need you to be clear. I will wait for you, for you. I will wait for you. I will wait for you. Yeah, babe. Can you put the time on a rewind? Yeah. Help me understand. Can you tell me now why you made a war that we're fighting now? And you fall and you run when you see my big guns run around, run away as the rebel comes out. There you go, call on me when you call me, I come. But then you go again. With your deaf ears, open your mind to the sound of the trumpet. What do you want from a life of the hopeless? Now yeah, you are, you're begging and crying. I want to fly, yeah, I'm flying to morning. Running away to the land of discovery. Running away from the suffering I'm calling. Yeah. Running away from the darkness I'm out, yeah, yeah. I had done all the limits, going way beyond the noise in your feelings. When you speak, all I can hear is silence. Running back from all the pain and violence. Big tunes, now it's big tunes, I'm kidding. Cry now from the shine, now call my name. Fall down when you see me, you know that I was there for you. I will wait for you, for you. I will wait for you. I will wait for you.
Y'all heard the news, right? The southern border in Texas is still letting migrants in, and guess what?
Oh, Top of the top, man. It's Monday number three, man. It's hump day. Y'all know what time it is, man. It's yours truly, CEO. I'm right back at y'all, man. I told y'all I was coming back, and I'm going to keep the goddamn heat coming, man. Shout out to everybody that's clocked in, getting to that paper this morning, man. It's 9 o'clock in the morning here in Texas. If you're in California, it's 7. If you're on the East Coast, it's 10. If you're anywhere else around the world, shit, I don't know what time it is, but you here with me. So it's time that we get this shit cracking, man, because we in this bitch, man. Hopefully you up getting some money. Hopefully you ain't listening to me laying down in the bed. I prefer you to be up, moving around, trying to get you a little piece of change before you do something strange. You understand what I'm saying? Yesterday we had a motherfucking... Somebody knocked at a nigga door while he was live on YouTube and the nigga didn't want to answer. They tell you everything you need to know about a nigga living condition. If a motherfucker knock on your door and a nigga get still and nigga play invisible like he ain't there, nigga on his ass, man. Nigga living with other people, man. Yeah, nigga living with other people, man. Straight up. I mean, to tell y'all, man, nigga is not in control of their living condition, man. You know what I'm saying? Goddamn people start knocking on the door and the nigga start spraying. Motherfucker knocked on the door. Motherfucker start knocking. Nigga start spraying everywhere. Nigga, where you live at, nigga? Nigga out here in the free world living on closed custody. Nigga on closed custody in the free world, man. Again, they tell you everything you need to know about these niggas and their living conditions. If a motherfucker knock on your door and you start spraying shit and you get quiet, you living in prison. Shake down. Nigga had a shakedown yesterday. Bitch ass nigga ain't got no control of the situation, man. But once again, I digress because y'all think I just be making this shit up. This shit is real life. Nigga, these niggas broke for real. Straight up, man. These niggas broke for real. Yeah, nigga about to get put out on live, as Pico say. Eviction notice, nigga. Nigga froze and got quiet. Nigga, what you doing? Nigga, is it a raid? Nigga, they done raided the homeless shelter. Nigga start spraying incense and shit. Nah, bitch ass nigga. It's the tent. You ain't pay. Ain't nobody paid no rent there. It's eviction time around this motherfucker. You on your goddamn ass. Yeah, that's what's going on. It's goddamn eviction time, nigga. What it is? April 10th? Man, how that rent go if you ain't paid it by the 10th? Man, I'm gonna tell you straight up. If I ain't paid rent by the 10th, I don't plan on paying it. Yeah. If it get to the 10th and I ain't paid the rent, I ain't gonna pay it. Yeah. You gotta catch me next month. Boy, these niggas on their ass. But see, when it get to the 10th, they quit sending letters. They start knocking. Yeah, motherfuckers start showing up at the front door and nigga freeze. Nigga get invisible and shit. Boy, these niggas on their ass. Nigga, I'm talking about nigga living bad as a motherfucker, man. But I digress, man. For those that tuning in, man, this is the goddamn me morning show. It's yours truly, CEO Hockley. And this is what we do every morning, man. So what we gonna do is this. Because if you knock on that door, call that phone, we gonna get right to it because we ain't at home. We at work. We clocked in, we getting to a bag, so we ain't worried about nobody knocking because we already paid the goddamn bills. So this is what we're going to do, man. We're going to bring the minister in here to bless the goddamn show, and we're going to get this goddamn show rolling, man. Let's go. Let's do this here.
The path that I'm on, this little black brother can never die. What? What? What are you saying, Farrakhan? You won't die? I'll go like all other men. But the ideas and the truth that I represent, it will live and it will continue to strike the hearts of men. And I am promised in the book that honor will be heaped upon my name long after I'm dead and gone. I'm not looking for no honor from this world. I don't care nothing about the president or the Senate or the Congress or the world honoring me. I want to be honored by God.
Top of the top. You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and counter.
It's time to get up and count up, man. Goddamn landlord ain't looking for us. Yeah, roommate, nigga, that's a sale. Ain't got no motherfucking roommate, nigga. You gotta sell it, nigga. Hey, when we was in prison, they had different levels, right, of custody, right? You had general population, medium custody, and cold custody. Nigga on cold custody out here in the free world, man. Yeah, y'all better quit listening to these niggas living on cold custody, man. Gonna get the goddamn show started, man, as usual, right? We're gonna bring up these topics. And we got CEO thought of the day. After CEO thought of the day, we're gonna get to the South Carolina National Championship, man. Listen, we gotta honor these people, man. We got to honor greatness, man. Undefeated. Beat the best of the best. Y'all see what that sign say right there? To be the best, you got to beat the best. And that's what South Carolina Gamecocks did, man. Went undefeated, man. Great, great year. Had more viewers than the men's championship, man. These young ladies did their thing. We also talk about what's beef, man. J. Cole bitch ass copped out, man. Niggas, man, these niggas is hoes. Yeah, these niggas is real live bitches. Nigga copped out in a rap beef he could have won. Man, you's a bitch. Yeah, straight up. And then BG got violated for parole for doing shit with rappers, right? They say the rappers that he's doing music with are convicted felons and he can't do that. So they took him to jail. Man, you know how many motherfuckers got felonies, work together right now, on a job? Nigga, you got to go arrest the whole Popeyes. Hell is you talking about? And I ain't just talking about niggas. I'm talking about the women in there, too. They felons, too. Nigga, you got to go arrest the whole goddamn Walmart. If you goddamn me can't work with people that been to jail before, shit, everybody need to go to jail. But, you know, they able to pick and choose, and they pick the ones that's making it work for them. And that's how this society is fucked up. You understand? But we be right back with all them topics, man. We coming in right back after the goddamn break. CEO thought of the day coming up next. Let's roll.
I'm not going to lie and portray this ultimate poise like I've been had it figured out. No, I just didn't quit. That's the only distinguishing quality from me and probably whoever else going through this or went through this or is going to go through this is that I quit.
This is dedication. Anti-hesitation. It's a brick and celebration. It's a dime block declaration. 59th and 5th Ave, granny house with vanilla wafers. It's the remedy to separation. Tupac of my generation. Blue pill in the f***ing matrix. Red rose in the gray pavement. Young black trapped and he can't change it. No, he a genius, he just can't claim it. Cause they left him no platform to explain it. He frustrated so he get faded. But deep down inside he know you can't fade.
Hermes. Okay. It's from East Africa, it's from Eritrea. She like, your name mean God will rise. And I thought that was dope.
I need some real reparations. Or I run up in your bank just for recreation. Dedication, hard work, plus patience. To some more of my sacrifice, I'm done waiting. Told you that I wasn't playing. Now you hear what I've been saying. Dedication. Dedication.
I read somewhere that the highest human act is to inspire. And we all are in search of inspiration every day. So events like this and just opportunities to be able to either inspire or be inspired, I think, is what creates movements.
I look at it like, you know, we honor the people that ain't quit. We honor the people that stayed down.
Yo, we right back in here. Put a one in the chat if you could hear me, man. Put that one in the chat if you could hear me, man. Where my audio engineer at? Where the audio engineer? Where K Ree is at? The audio engineer gone? Man, you can't get these niggas no jobs. Not these young niggas. Oh, there you go. Okay, there you go. Yeah, you can't get these young niggas no job, man. These young niggas gonna fuck you right over, man. Off top, man. Let's do this here, man. We're in the building, man. Shout out to everybody that's tapped in. Shout out to everybody. Listen, man, it's yours truly, CEO Hockley, and you are tapped in to the livest goddamn morning show on YouTube. CEO, how you know this is the livest morning show, nigga? Because I said so. Fuck is you talking about? You think I'm gonna say somebody else shit live than mine, nigga? Please, fuck you. Yeah. Fuck you. What the hell is you talking about, man? We gonna get right to this shit, man. Ain't no doubt about it. Shout out to all my people that's in the building, man. We got K Riz always in the building. He the sound engineer, but he been fucking up since he got the job. When he didn't have the job, that nigga was on point. I gave him a job. He didn't already start stealing, putting a one in the chat before I even start talking. Like, yeah, niggas just be, man, niggas is niggas. But hey, I love you niggas, I guess, because I ain't got away from you niggas. They're lovely. The corner levels is in the building, man. She always tapped in, telling y'all to hit that like, hit that share button. This shit is free. You know what I'm saying? Always showing support. We got the Prince in the building. He got the livest goddamn me sports show on the goddamn planet, man. He be over there with the background. He got the drops. He got all that shit. Now, he a Rockets fan, and he be crying. And I ain't with all that shit. They like them Dallas Cowboys fan. Them niggas lose so much, they just cry. You know what I'm saying? That's the only thing. That's the only criticism I got by this show. He a diehard Rockets fan, and he be over there crying like a motherfucker. Yeah, that's it. He got to cut that shit out. My nigga got money in the building, riding, and dropped off them kids, and then punched that clock some goddamn well. Pico the Dawn in this motherfucker. Yeah, Pico the Dawn in this bitch, man. Taking care of business, slop, slaying hoe-ass niggas, using hoe-ass niggas. He got all loco content. He done made so much money off loco, it don't make no sense. He need to be sending Loco some money. Loco, Loco need reparations from you, man. Yeah, you done had that nigga in a slave contract for 3 years, man. Is you gonna pay them reparations? You need to pay Loco reparations for all that motherfucking me ass sense money you done got. You got all that motherfucking ass sense money out that old nigga and ain't gave him no money. Yeah, you need to pay reparations, Pico. All right, man, that's what we're going to get to, man. CEO thought of the day, man. We're going to keep the goddamn show rolling. Hold on. Y'all know I fucks up. Let me bring this up. We right back in here, man. Monday number three, man. We on CEO thought of the day, man. And this is what I want to share with y'all, man. I want to share with these beautiful people that are listening to the sound of my voice right now, man. Listen, stay down for what you put down. I know we heard that saying a couple times. We heard that a few times, but do we really stay down for what we put down, man? Got a phrase here from Wallow, guy that did 20 years in prison, got out, and goddamn me, put his foot to the ground and saved his goddamn life. It's what Wallow 267 say. He say, I truly believe that if you put the work in for 12 to 36 months, it's definitely going to pop off for you. But if you let go of your dream during that time, I guarantee you will see someone else taking off with what you wanted to do. Don't stop. Don't stop, man. I'm gonna read that again. I truly believe that if you put the work in, hold on, let me bring myself back up, man. Let me do it like this here. Yeah, man, this is Wallo, man. This is what he's saying, man. Wallo 267 say, I truly believe that if you put the work in for 12 to 36 months, right, 1 year to 3 years, it's definitely going to pop off for you. But if you let go of your dreams during that time, I guarantee you will see someone else taking off with what you want to do. Don't stop. Okay, so he's saying the 12 to 36 months. We kind of talked about that in a previous CEO thought of the day. That's what we're talking about, staying consistent. The problem is people can't stay consistent that long, 12 months to 36 months. People can't do one thing or develop a routine for a 12-month period. That is the hardest part to do. Because why? People want to go in all motivated and all gung-ho and get burnt out, right? But they can't stay consistent. They can't put that drop on the thing every day. That's what y'all see here with the morning show. We right now into our 18-month plan that we running all the way to January 2025. Well, what happens in January 25, CEO? Nothing. Other than that, we completed our goal, we stay consistent, and then we create another one. We just keep going. We assess where we at, change what we need to change, and then we keep moving. Most people can't do that, but all the successful people, all the people with longevity, all the people that's been around, they make a plan and they stick to it. They don't care what's going on. They don't care who winning the championship. They don't care who doing this, who doing that. They do not care because they stick into their routine and they stick into their plan long enough to see it manifest. It's called the compound effect. And anything you do a little bit at will pile up to a lot. Yeah, anything you do consistently will add up to a lot over time. Time is the thing that we do not put into play. Time is the thing that we do not know how to calculate because we give up. We want to plant the seed today and eat the fruit today. It don't work like that. You got to plant the seed and you got to water it. You got to work it and you got to wait for it to grow. But once that seed grows, once that seed comes out the ground, once that seed bears fruit, it bears fruit for you forever. Listen to what I'm telling you. Don't let people trick you and fool you and think you wasting your time. When you plant the apple seed and the apple seed grows into an apple tree and it starts giving apples, it give apples forever. God made this world abundant. It give apples forever. Listen, the minute you put in the work and the minute that tree grows, it gives you apples forever. Do you understand what I'm telling you here? The only time it comes restricted is that once you put the seed in the ground and it grows and it give apple, a motherfucking man, a white man, will put a fence around that tree and charge you for the apples. That's how the shit get fucked up. But God set this shit up to be abundant, man. Once you put in the work, it will give to you forever. But you have to understand that the goddamn apple tree don't grow in no day. You goddamn got to understand how long it take for an apple tree to mature and how long does it take for it to produce apples and when it's harvest season and when it's planting season. And once you understand that and once you stick to the rules of success, that goddamn apple tree will feed you apples forever. And that's what y'all got to understand, man. Stay down for what you put down. Just because you've been doing something for a long time don't mean you got progress at it or that you've been doing it right. But if you stay down long enough, right, you'll be able to see the results on the wall. When a motherfucker come knocking on the door, you've been putting down what you're supposed to have been putting down, you ain't got to worry about getting quiet or being still, right? You can go right to that motherfucking door and answer. Fuck you knocking on my door for, nigga? Yeah, fuck you doing on my door? Yeah, that's how that shit happens. When you get up every morning and you take care of your business, man, stay down for what you put down, your time gonna come. Unless you are bullshitting and wasting your time and eating your seeds the same day you planted, man. That's the CEO thought of the day. Hopefully you can put that feather in your hat and that could do something for you, man. We're gonna move on to the next topic. The next topic coming up is gonna be South Carolina and the national championships, man. We're gonna celebrate these sisters and what they have done and what they have did. It's real live history in the making that we saw. Somebody putting something down and picking something up a couple years later. That's exactly what they did, man. Let's roll.
When whites ran everything, Jack Johnson took orders from no one. While most African Americans struggled merely to survive, Jack Johnson reveled in his riches and his fame. When black Americans were expected to defer to whites, Jack Johnson battered them to the ground. And at a time when the mere suspicion that a black man had flirted with a white woman could cost him his life, Jack Johnson slept with whomever he pleased.
You know what free is, nigga? What's free? Free is when nobody else can tell us what to be. Free is when the TV ain't controlling what we see. Told my nigga I need you. Do all the fame, you know I stay true. Pray my nigga stay free. Made a few mistakes, but this ain't where I wanna be. Before I'm judged by 12, put a 12 on my feet. Told my nigga I need you. Stay up, I know these times ain't true. Real life, what's
just
free?
Just the lad I was cunning, just got a pad out in London. I keep stacking my money, I need a...
Top of the top. You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and count up.
Yes, sir. It's time to get up and count up, man. We woke, man. We alive. We here, man. We putting that work in, cuz y'all know what time it is, man. We not bullshitting. We getting right to it over here. Shout out to my people that just checked in, man. Shout out to the homie Fat Loke. He in the building. Shout out to goddamn me, Stoner's Committee. What it do, homie? Shout out to Dr. Diamond. Dr. Diamond, D-Town's African Princess, is in the building. See how I put that together, Diamond? D-Town's African Princess is in the building, man. Shout out to Dr. Diamond, man. We keeping the show rolling. We keeping this shit jumping, man. Listen, man, real quick, man. South Carolina National Championship, man. That's what we finna get to, man. We gonna get to that, right? After we take a quick break. I gotta get my people in here on Instagram, man. They been hitting me up, talking about they waiting for the show. Again, they don't wanna jump over to YouTube. They wanna stay on Instagram. But they say they waiting on the show. Where the show at, CEO? We looking for the show, but we don't see it, right? And I'm like, listen, man. I got a break to bring them in, but we gonna rock out during the break. Y'all know.
I'm a hungry individual. I want to grow. I want to learn. I came across the Google Career Certificate.
My boss. So we gotta give y'all some dope, man. Listen, what y'all know about this here? Hold on, man. Damn, where did I put that thing? I need to play this video for y'all, man. I need to give y'all some inspiration real quick, man. Let's see if I can give y'all some inspiration real quick, man. Damn, I don't know where it's at, though. I got something dope for y'all that just came to my mind when I was finna play this song. Yeah, I got something dope for y'all. And Fat Loke, you came to my mind when I goddamn me was ready to play this song. Hold on, let me see. Maybe I can pull this up. Let's see. Let me see real quick. Give me 1 second. Y'all know I get sidetracked and all fucked up. You know what I'm saying? I don't be knowing shit, nigga. I'm in this motherfucker thugging, fucking shit up. Cause I'm fucked up, man. Yeah, I ain't got it all. Uh-oh, I think I found it though. I might not got it all, but I think I found it. Hold on. Wait. Let me see if I can share this. Cool. This is how I'm going to the break. Give y'all some inspiration. Fat Loke. You on here, Fat Loke? All right, listen, man, real quick. I'm finna bring my Instagram people in here, man. I want to show y'all this video. This is my homeboy, Randy Morton, man. It's a birthday we put together for him, right? After doing 26 years in prison. Y'all done saw him on the show. Right, he one of the ones that we had a sit down interview with, right? And this is, as y'all see in this steer, they go Randy, they go me, they go my son Truven. This was 4 years ago when he first got out and his first birthday, right? After doing 26 years in prison, this is his first birthday, and you know, this put together by our neighborhood celebrating his struggle and celebrating him coming home. He's doing extremely well now. But this was his first birthday, man. Y'all check this out, man. I hope y'all enjoy this while I get my Instagram people in here. And it got one of my favorite songs that I was finna play. And we used that song as background music for Randy's birthday. 26 years, his first birthday home, and we celebrated the homie.
Hey, so what if them niggas make more? I knew my time would come and had to wait for it. So every night a nigga pray for it. Ain't no going back, the only way is for it. See, some people, they weren't made for it. They roll it in my rear like it was made for it. And they hate it, but what's the hate for? Ain't no stopping for it, we need breaks for it.
Second birthday to my homeboy Randy. Been a long time coming, man. My car is always in control, man. Always.
I'm at they neck, ain't no letting know. No fuck up. A vest, get you naked enough. Life is chess, so I set them off. Life's a gamble, I got hella love. Told her we can fuck, but don't get comfortable. No. Ain't no shit.
Say, man, yeah, man, we here. We celebrate my homeboy, Randy White. For his happy birthday, you know what I'm saying? First time home, 26 years. Remember love. We miss him, love him. We gonna stay here.
My car driving fast, you're uncomfortable. Yeah. I just flooded out my ring, look like a Royal Rumble. They say money talk, then I'm
Randy White, man. 26 tight, man. I ain't never told on nobody. Nigga. Came home, not look at me. That's what's up.
No bullshit. No bullshit. Real shit, man. Boy, I called this shit down, man.
26 years ain't told on nobody.
Hey, look, man. Hey, yeah, them partners and shit, man. Say, I've been to every visit, man. I've been to every visit, every
crap. Man, no matter what I make, I still remain humble. That's word to my mama. It's a cold world, streets cold, dog. Gotta keep it burning. So what if them niggas?
Man, I wanna wish a happy birthday, happy 42nd birthday to my good friend, Randy Martin, aka Rando, Lil Randy. Happy birthday to you, bro. I wish you many, many more.
Let's make more. I knew my time would come and had to wait for it. So every night a nigga pray for it. Ain't no going back, the only way is for it.
That's my kinfolk, know what I'm saying? My mama's sister, first blood. Happy 42nd birthday, more to come. You know what I'm saying? I'm free, we'll always be free.
Some people they weren't made for. They roll it in my rear like it was made for. And they hate it, but what's the hate for? Yeah. Ain't no stopping for, we need breaks for.
Hey, what's happening? They call me the Fizzler. It's now Fizzler. I'm here to support my old boy Randy Martin, man. Welcome home, homie.
See, I can't lose, we don't lose. A million way to get it, little nigga just choose. I chose to go and eat, we weren't having food.
It's a G-Time 5, OG Cat Daddy, man. Clowns turn. Happy birthday to my boy, man. Been gone a long time, glad to see you home, man. Good luck to you, man. You doing the right thing with the right people. One.
So my nigga how to eat, I ain't had nothing to pull. We was skipping school, trying to go on the moon. The hood day coming up, shit, I'ma need some shoes. Might catch for an outfit, shit, that'll be a fool.
Say, shout out to my boy Randy, birthday. His first birthday, he ain't been home in so long. Keep your head up, stay on the right path.
And one thing about Luch, I never needed to. I swear I can't wait to turn up. Look what we've been through. Lost both of my cousins this year.
Man, glad to see you. Man, happy birthday, my nigga.
Shout out my nigga Randy. It's my birthday, man.
Hey, happy birthday, man. My nigga Randy, man.
Happy birthday, your boy Randy, man.
Happy birthday to my boy Randy, man. Good to be home.
Yeah, on my side, we ride for Icon. And then they tell you I don't play about mine. Hey, so what if them niggas make more? I knew my time would come and had to wait for. So every night a nigga pray for. Ain't no going back, the only way is for.
Shout out to my nigga Randy, man. Showing love to my nigga, man. Glad he home, man. Real talk, man. Shout out to my nigga Randy, man.
Happy birthday. Stay up. Keep winning. Yeah.
See, some people they weren't made for. They roll it in my rear like it was made for. And they hate it, but what's the hate for?
Yeah. Ain't no stopping for we need brace yeah. for. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm good, man. I'm motivated.
Happy.
I'm very happy. And I'm still at work, man. And I ain't stopping until I get where I want to be. And it's all in the time frame. And I don't know. I didn't quit it now. All I did was change to get there. So at this point, I'm not gonna stop.
Hey.
And I ain't going back to living how I used to live. Because I refuse to go back to prison. So whatever I got, everybody else out there, man, just find your focus, positive focus, man, and positive motivation, find your positive energy. Because that negative energy ain't going to get you nowhere, either to the grave or to the prison.
Put a one in the chat if you can hear me, man. I'm right back in here, man. Type one in the chat if you can hear me. I don't know if y'all can hear me. Shout out to my Instagram people. I got y'all tapped in now. Put a one in the chat if you can hear me. I don't even know if y'all can hear me, man. Okay, K-Rea is in the building. Cool, y'all can hear me. Yeah, man. I took that break, man, to bring in my Instagram people. It's one of my favorite songs, Lucci, right? And so instead of just playing the song, I played a video from 4 years ago of my good friend of mine, Randy Getnot, man. That's that's his first party, his first birthday free after 26 years of prison. Again, if y'all don't know nothing else about CEO, if y'all don't know nothing else about G County or Cedar Terrace, about our community, we take care of our own, man. That's just what you do. You see some of the fellas from the neighborhood, Cedar Terrace projects in which we grew up in, right? Giving Randy his flowers and welcome him back to society, man. He hasn't been back to jail. He actually get off parole this year, this June, in a few more months. He gets off parole and he plan on flying out the country, man. He's doing very good. He just came back from a job in Philadelphia, right? And Randy been doing his thing, man. Why? Because that's the way God set it up. God put the right people in his life so he could have something great. Not no fucking gang people, not no fucking internet bullshit people, but the right people to help him readjust to society and be able to help other people, man. And that's real results from real people. That's what we do all the time before the internet. That was in 2020 when niggas was on the internet trying to get an audience and try to get a following. Nigga was out here helping. One hand was washing the other, man. We was out here helping each other make sure that we got our life right, make sure that we become men and become productive people in this society. And hey, that's the proof of that, and that's some of the evidence, man. Shout out to Rando, shout out to Lucci. He finna come home. Some people wasn't made for it. I mean, I think that's just a dope song, man. I knew my time was coming. I had to wait for it. They go in line with the CEO thought of the day that we had earlier. But with that being said, man, we're going to go on to the next topic. Our next topic was South Carolina winning the national championship, man. South Carolina won the national championship on Sunday, man. Here we are Wednesday talking about it. And I just want to come in here and give them people their flowers, man. Straight up. I want to give the people their flowers for goddamn me going after something and achieving something, right? And making things happen that people normally don't make happen. Getting shit done. Right, you can't help but salute that, man. You can't help but honor that, man. When people get shit done, when people chase their dreams and then they achieve it, not only did they win the national championship, but they went undefeated. Yeah, they went undefeated, and this is their coach's third national championship, you know what I'm saying, in a particular sport, in a particular field, man. I think that is dope. These things have to be acknowledged because these things ain't no easy feats, they are not no easy accomplishments. Everybody is not holding up that trophy. Yeah, everybody is not holding up that trophy. Straight up, man. Dawn Stanley and the South Carolina Gamecocks have won a national championship. Number three, they finished a perfect 38-0, becoming the first team to finish undefeated since 2016, man. Listen, kudos to them, bro. They put that work in. They did what was necessary. And just as women, right, being able to get to the top of your field, man, is not an easy feat, man. So we want to honor that, man. We want to respect that. Let me see if I had some more footage of that. I had some more. Thought I had some more stuff, but let's Google that, man. Yeah, because that's dope, man. Straight up. I mean, knowing from where they came from, putting it down, and then they went up against the famous girl, Caitlyn. However you say her name, I don't want to fuck up her name. Yeah, I don't want to mess up her name, but they went up against her and they dominated. Oh, yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about. So that's what I wanted to speak on. I wanted to bring them up, but I also wanted to speak on something. I wanted to speak on this. Last year, the Caitlyn lady, let's bring her up, man. So, because everybody don't watch this shit. Everybody don't pay attention to this shit. But the girl that has took over college basketball, I don't even know how to say her name. I will fuck up her name. Y'all know I will fuck up her name. Somebody say her name. Do I need to put it in Google? And I ain't got that video. Yeah, I ain't got it, goddamn, in video, but goddamn, they got all kind of explosions and shit on this goddamn motherfucker. They went off. Yeah, they had 18 million views, man. Let's read this here real quick. Let me read this. The women's national championship game that pitted South Carolina against Iowa smashed a TV ratings record for the most watched women basketball game ever. The numbers of viewers peaked at 24 million and drew an average of 18 million viewers during the game, in which South Carolina prevailed over Caitlin Clark, Iowa. Right? It was a powerhouse game. It was a fitting finality to end a lot of these players that's played. This was their last time playing. A few of the players will be going on to be professionals. This was their last time playing in college, and 24 million people watched. But it was something very significant about this that y'all need to understand about this game. It's something very significant on why I brought up this game now, and why I also wanted to show y'all the CEO thought of the day. Because in this game, one of the girls from last year was mocked by this Caitlin Clark person, right? They was mocked. They was waved off, and they came back and they got revenge this year. She did not play. Raven Johnson, yep, got revenge for the way she was treated, for the way she was handled. She got total revenge. And this is how you should be. Your revenge come in time. It took her 12 months, took her a year to get this revenge, but she got her revenge. Let's play this here.
Watch Caitlin Clark, left side. She doesn't even look at her. She waves her off. Hand as if to say, I don't care about you.
She waves her off. Hold on, man. I need that. I need that to be full motherfucking view. I need the full goddamn view. God damn it. I do not need that. All right, here you go here. Here we go here. Here we go. I knew I was going to find this motherfucker. We need to watch this fully. We don't need to half-ass watch this. Here she go here, y'all. Look. All right. This is Raven Johnson dribbling the ball up top. If y'all notice, no. Oh, wait. Let me take this down. Put this here. Yeah, this is Raven Johnson dribbling the ball up top. If y'all notice, nobody is holding her. She is wide open. Look at her dribbling all by herself. And Caitlin Clark supposed to hold her, but she waved her off like she trash. She's not even holding. She's just sitting in the paint. They should have called 5 seconds on her ass. She refused to hold the girl. She said the girl is no good. Look at her. She finna wave her off. Oh, goddamn. Here it is again. She just waves her off like, you trash. I'm not going to even come out there and hold you. Well, that girl, she waved off last year. That little sister, she waved off last year, right? Waved her right on off. got revenge on her ass this year, man. This what I'm telling you. Wait your time. Your time coming. Your time coming. Here she go, picking her, stealing the ball from her this year. Stealing the ball from her this year. Look at her. Stealing the ball from her this year. Your motherfucking time coming. Wave me off now. Where your wave at? Your wave ain't working. My wave is working. Give me that. Give me that. Give me that. They went undefeated, man. They went undefeated, bro. Yeah, with no fanfare. They went motherfucking undefeated. Yeah, so what you're saying, CEO, what I'm saying is this, man. Your time coming, man. Stay down for what you put down. And when it's time to show up, show up. Last year, she got waved off. We didn't even know nothing about it. We didn't really hear too much about it. But this year, when everybody was watching, when the most people ever watched the women's championship game, 24 million people watched her get her revenge. And seeing the number one women's player in the country out of college with no trophy. The number one women's player in college has left college with no trophy. Yeah, no wins. Imagine Tom Brady. We saying Tom Brady is the greatest quarterback that ever played a game, but he never won a ring. That's Caitlin Clark. She never won, right? She never won. So when the whole world was watching, that sister Raven Johnson got her revenge in front of the whole world, dominated her that whole game, had her upset, had her frustrated, had her wondering what was going on, all because the year before, she chose to wave that girl off, and that girl ain't play like that, man. That's how you got to stand on business. That's how you got to take care of business, man. Yeah, you got to put it down like that. You cannot let nobody play with you. You cannot let nobody handle you. You have to goddamn me take care of your business and stand on it. Do not play with these people, man. Let these people know who you are and what you stand for.
Raven, Caitlin had the big start, 18 points in the first quarter. You got that defensive assignment primarily after that and really cooled her off. What was your mindset going into that matchup?
Don't let her score. I mean, I was ready. I was ready for the moment, and I take defense very hard. Like, I take it to heart, and I think I studied her moves, and I was ready. I had confidence this year. I mean, I was telling myself last year's not going to happen again, so.
Raven, Caitlin had the big start, 18 points in the first quarter. You got that defensive assignment primarily after that and really cooled her off. What was your mindset really going into that matchup?
Don't let her score. I mean, I was ready. I was ready for the moment, and I take defense very hard. Like, I take it to heart, and I think I studied her moves, and I was ready. I had confidence this year. I mean, I was telling myself last year's not going to happen again, so.
Yeah, last year not going to happen again, man. She convinced herself, man, that she could do it, man. I'm the better player. Fuck all the attention. Fuck all the likes. Fuck all the views. Fuck all the comments. I'm the better player, and now I get to show it. And she shut her down, and they came away with the ring. South Carolina undefeated, man. Kudos to those women. Shout out to what they done. They also got a black coach over there. Man, they did their thing, man. Salute to them, right? And you, too, can hold up your championship. Stay down for what you put down, man. We are the greatest creatures ever formed. But once you convince yourself you can't do it, that's what happened. The dude over Ford Motor said this here, man. The man who think he can and the man who think he can't are both right, man. It all starts with the way you think and the way you see yourself, man. Yeah. You are a goddamn champion. You just got to see yourself as that, and you got to put in the work to get there, man. And that's that, man. With that, I'm going to digress. We're going to move on to the next topic. What's beef, man? Shout out to the South Carolina Gamecocks. Shout out to what they did, man. Salute from CEO Hockey, man, in the morning show, man. We are inspired.
Love.
Galveston County, area code 409. So when we started the company, we wanted to represent that. This is a Galveston County company, and we're located in the 409 area code. Try to specialize in not making shirts, but in customer service.
Are you young wild girls? You make a mess of me. Yeah, you young wild girls. You'll be the death of me. The death of me. Are you young wild girls? No matter what you do. Yeah, you young wild girls. I always come back to you. Come back.
You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and counter.
Yo, we right back in the building, man. Type of one in the chat if you can hear me. What's up, K-Riz? Can you hear me, homie? Can you hear me? Am I clear to you, man? What's up? Put a one in the chat if you can hear me, man. We're in the goddamn building, man. It's hump day. I know what it is, man. It's goddamn hump day. OG Hollywood put a two in the goddamn chat. What's up, OG Hollywood, man? Day room time tonight. We got that day room tonight, man. We're going to talk about that too. But right now, we're going to talk about what's beef, man. Yeah, we're going to move on to the next topic, man. What's beef in 2024, man? You know, we have some different hip-hop music celebrities beefing with each other. We got J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar comes out and diss everybody, right? And then J. Cole make a response. Well, something different happened this time, right? What different happened this time, CEO? Well, something very different happened this time. After dissing the person that dissed him, right?
I know one is just a lead up. It's just an EP that leads me up to this thing that I've been working on for a long time. And I know the work it took to get to a certain type of skill level. And I love this shit. So that shit mean a lot to me, right? So I'm so proud of that project, except for one part. It's one part of that shit that make me feel like, man, that's the lamest shit I ever did in my fucking life, right? And I know this is not what a lot of people want to hear. I know I can hear my niggas up there right now like, nah, don't do that. But I got to keep it 100 with y'all, right? I damn near had a relapse, right? Because y'all heard some shit that happened two, three weeks ago, however long it was. Y'all heard that bazooka that was dropped on the motherfucking game, right? So all of this time of me moving on my own accord, for the first time I was tested. Why am I tested? Because I got the world. And I got my niggas like, oh, proud of that project because I know one, it's just a lead up. It's just an EP that leads me up to this thing that I've been working on for a long time. And I know the work it took to get to a certain type of skill level. And I love this shit. So that shit mean a lot to me, right? So I'm so, what you gonna do, Cole? Jab my nigga back. And I try to keep it friendly. But at the end of the day, when I listen to it and when it comes out and I see the talk, that shit don't sit right with my spirit. That shit make me feel. That shit disrupts my fucking peace. So what I want to say right here tonight is in the midst of me doing that and in that shit, trying to find a little angle and downplay this nigga's fucking catalog and his greatness, I want to say right now tonight, how many people think Kendrick Lamar is one of the greatest motherfuckers to ever touch a fucking microphone? Dreamville, y'all love Kendrick Lamar, correct? As do I. So I just want to come up here and be like, publicly be like, bro, that was the lamest, like, goofiest shit. And I say all that to say, it made me feel like 10 years ago when I was moving incorrectly. And I pray that God align me back up on my purpose and on my path. You know what I mean? I pray that my nigga really didn't feel no way. And if he did, my nigga, I got my chin jab my.
Man, listen. She talking about shout out to J. Cole. J. Cole, a sucker, man. J. Cole, that was some sucker shit, Diamond. That ain't no man shit. That's some goddamn sucker shit, man. We don't, We do not respect that faggot ass shit. This is the end of the world. Look what Lil Duval say, man. Let's check out what Lil Duval say about that nigga doing this sucker shit. Lil Duval say this. He say, how you give up on a rap? How do you give up in a rap beef you guaranteed not to die from? The whole reason we like Kendrick and J. Cole beef was because we knew it was friendly competition. Nobody saw it as bad energy or negative. So get the fuck out of here with that narrative. Man, you got to call the show, Diamond. You got to call the goddamn show, man. How the fuck? See, that's what I'm saying about society right now, right? Like, these people are entertainers. And the only way to be the best is the same way we just said in the other segment, right? South Carolina had to go up against one of the greatest players of college basketball. To be the best, you got to beat the best. You got to go up against the best. You have to have a competitive nature to go up against the best, especially when you are being called out. You got to call, it's called competing. Where do you get this negative energy from? Oh, because you got to talk trash while you compete. Yes, you got to have a diverse mentality to whatever you're going up against so you can have the right energy to draw from so you can be great. You don't get pushed forward by shaking people's hand. Good guys finish last, nigga. This is the facts of the matter. Hello?
What up, Aqua? This is Diamond.
Oh, here you go, man.
What is it?
All right, explain to us why J. Cole is being a man.
All I want to say was, what's up to the chat? So, what's up to the chat also? All I'm saying is this. It wasn't even Cole fight. It was between Kendrick and Drake initially, right? From what I'm understanding. Cole just really jumped in on some Me Too shit, right? So, of course, he not as, you know what I'm saying, like, to him, he like, you know what, I'm tripping. You know, tell me you ain't never just did that, like, you know what, I inserted myself into this shit. Let's go ahead and get the fuck on, you know what I'm saying? The nigga Cole been going through a lot anyway. He been saying in his songs. He got a couple songs where he was saying he going through, you know what I'm saying, now that he a daddy and all this stuff, you know, life been real for him. You know, nigga even gonna sit this one out, my bad. That's all I'm saying. Listen to me. At least he wasn't, you know what I'm saying, he gonna keep it with you. You know, Kendrick ain't bad. You know, he's still the GOAT. My bad. You know, let me sit back. What's wrong with that? You know, what's wrong with that?
Man, if that nigga don't go sit his bitch ass down somewhere, what you mean what's wrong with that? If that nigga don't go sit his light-skinned ass down somewhere.
No offense to nobody in the chair. You know, I know we all of different shades, but that's that light-skinned shit right there.
Man, listen.
Low battery.
Listen.
And because it's not really his battle. You know what I'm saying? Let me step back. Man. You know? So at least he wasn't no, you know what I'm saying? So he wasn't sitting on business. He wasn't fresh.
Now what I'm saying is this: a motherfucker call you out, you hit him with a stick, and you apologize for hitting him with the stick. Man, if you don't get your bitch ass out of here, yeah, man. Apology not accepted, man. It shows the whole time. It showed the whole time.
It go both ways, okay? I say it go both ways. He could have kept it going, yeah. He could, but nigga ain't got the energy for that shit.
Nah,
honestly, nigga ain't got the energy for this shit.
When you say
he had the energy, but then he lost it. And something happened, and he ain't got the energy for it. So I think it go both ways. He went wrong, he went right.
Man, that nigga was emotional. Yeah, nigga, that's what women do. Like, you emotional, my nigga. Listen, it is your job to clean up restrooms. A nigga shitted in the restroom, clean that bitch up. A nigga shitted on you. You know, a nigga felt a certain way, went in the studio and shitted on you. He dissed you and everybody else because the nigga who is dissing y'all wants to be greater. Yeah, he want to compete. He don't want to shake your motherfucking hand. Oh, I just want to announce that I love everybody. Man, if you don't get your Michael Jackson didn't fuck with Prince.
Yeah, I honestly feel like that was a little, he didn't plan that. That was a little impromptu.
That was
it just came out of nowhere. Nigga was feeling emotional that night, and it just came out.
Nigga,
it didn't even mean to happen like that. Because I really didn't even want to call him on the phone and told him that.
Man.
Man, you know what I'm saying? I think it just so happened he was at the concert. You know, if you've been to a concert, especially in front row, you know, I love to sit front row. If you've been to the concert, the energy be so real sometimes, the nigga just get emotional. The nigga was just in his feelings.
He got right on that stage with his big girl panties on and expressed himself.
Oh, yeah.
He put his big girl panties on and expressed himself, man.
I just don't feel like he right. I don't feel like he right. But just shout out to him for just being like, let me just get out the way. You know, my bad. But like Chris said in the chat, the this was for Drake. But Jake, you know, got a strike. Shit, that's all.
All right, I got a better question. Since you a female, you could help us out with this. Do good guys finish last?
Do good what?
Do good guys finish last?
Oh, hell yeah, I see them most wise. Not always, but a lot of the times they do. Yeah, yes, sir. Good guys do finish last. Because they, you know, they get overlooked. They, you know what I'm saying? A lot of times, yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. J. Cole, take your bitch ass to the back of the line. Party over, man.
Yeah, man. You know what? Set up. That was a setup, wasn't it? I just felt right for the strap. Okay, well, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah, take your bitch ass to the back of the line. You heard what the woman said.
To the back of the line, nigga.
To the back of the motherfucking line.
Nigga, don't you grab me no credit, no nothing. Don't grab. Don't pass go. Don't collect $200. Just back to the line.
Yeah,
damn.
We ain't even listening to
that. My like that.
We ain't even listening to that shit no more. He discredited his whole album with that shit. Now we know that.
The real fans gonna listen.
We know that album as the apology album. Back to the line, nigga. Good guys finish last. Vamoose, nigga, disappear. But
there ain't nothing wrong with it. You know, some of us is in our soft girl era. Cole is just in his soft man era. You know, soft, you know, he in his, let me call that shit, soft, man era. Yes, soft, you know, soft
girl,
life.
Soft girl era. Yeah. Yeah, he finna be like Playboy Cardi and pop out in the thong. Yeah,
he's going too far. No, sir. Absolutely not. If he do that, you cross the line. No, sir.
Yeah, man. Hip hop has entered this soft girl era. These niggas is gay. That's just what it is. Now,
you ain't said nothing wrong.
I appreciate you calling in. You been all right?
I've been straight, just busy working. You know me. I've been on the station I've been on, just busy working. But you know, I got to check it from time to time. But I'm going to holler at you later because I've been looking for my homegirl, Mocha Bird. She ain't been in the chat. Yeah, I did go. Yeah, Mocha Bird, where you at? We've been looking for you. Nah, you ain't been in the chat.
Now, listen.
We're going to talk about that.
Nah, we going to talk about that. Listen, man. Listen. Hold on. Let me pull this up. A few people done broke up with me, man. They didn't broke up with CEO. Now listen.
What you do?
I'ma tell you. The whole world wanna know. Look, I've been fucking up all my life. Listen what I'm telling you. Motherfucker that broke up with me. Listen. Y'all know I don't mean no harm, right? Y'all gotta know I don't mean no harm. I'm not always right. I'm fucked up. Listen, I'm fucked up. I'm not always right. I'ma cuss some people out. I'm going to cuss some people out on this motherfucker. I'm going to make some people mad. I think people done left me and got mad at me because I said, if you on the internet and you a woman, you either selling pussy or offering it for free. I think that was kind of offensive.
Yo, my. Why are you like this?
Why
you know, Dr. Diamond. Now we gotta talk about your feelings and shit. Why are you like this? For real.
Listen, I am who I am. And I'm not saying I'm right. I'm just giving you my explanation for what I experienced. but at the end of the day, I support everybody, man. Whether you're in the bushes, out the bushes. The show must go on, man. I do get love. Miss Mocha Bird ain't show me nothing but love. You know what I'm saying? And she still show me love. Shout out to Miss Sitting in the Tree. Miss Sitting in the Tree ain't show me nothing but love, and they still show me love. I hope, you know, on the flip side, I hope everything is straight on their end, which I assume it is.
No, but, for real.
Yeah, but,
for real.
But on the other side, I really don't know. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like it's all love. It's like this. It's two sides to every coin, man. Love is hate. Yeah. Hate is love. If a motherfucker hates you, they love you. If a motherfucker love you, they hate you. It's a two. You know how you be like, man, I hate this nigga. And you know you love that
you
nigga.
You love that nigga. That's why you hate them so much. You really love that nigga. That's why.
And you know that.
That's all.
So right. Mm-hmm. So right now, Miss Mocha Bird, Miss Sitting in the Tree, and I don't know, Puerto Rican, everybody else, they in their hate season. Yeah, but it's all love though.
Hate train on CEO. They
No, not.
Oh man, it ain't right.
Not hate as if they trying to stop me or prevent me from doing something. Not that kind of hate. It's the love to hate. Like I hate this nigga. You understand? They mad at me, so I get it. I ain't tripping though. It is what it is, man. It's all love. Hate is love. Love is hate. It's all the same, man. I appreciate it either way because on some real shit, they never done me nothing wrong. They only showed me love. So yeah. So they got a right to feel how they feel.
I'm the boy drive all that, you know? You've been through a lot, you know what I'm saying? And I want to say, in the words of Rodney King, can't we all just get along?
Yeah, nah.
Can we all just get along?
Nah, we can't because I'm abusive. I put people in abusive relationships. Yeah, I'm toxic.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
So, nah, man, I appreciate you tapping in. I appreciate them tapping in. I'm toxic, though. Yeah, I'm toxic as a motherfucker.
That's the problem. I'm glad that at least you admitted it. But you know what I'm saying? I'm going to jump back in the chat. We're going to continue from there.
All right.
Bye. All right.
Yeah, man. Shout out to my people, man. Shout out to my people who's always showing love, man. Everybody show CEO love. I always get love, man. It's one love over here, man. I'm a shit talker, so sometimes I offend people and piss people off. I've been doing it all my life, man. But shout out to those that's supporting. Shout out to those that's hating. And when I say hating, those that mad at me. If you're mad at me, that means you love me. And I appreciate the love, man. So, yeah, I ain't going to say hating. Shout out to those that love me. Shout out the ones that's mad at me, man. Because if you're mad at me, that means you love me. You do not get mad at things you don't fuck with. So I appreciate the people that love me, and I appreciate the people that's mad at me, man. It's all love. It's your boy, CEO Hockley, and we're going to go on to the next topic. BG violates his parole for working with people that was felons. Yeah, they violated BG, and we're going to get to that after the break, man. Shout out to Dr. Diamond for tapping in, man. Shout out to everybody in the chat. We're keeping the goddamn show rolling, man. Let's go.
Hey, everybody. It's Tasia Bonet representing Lamarck, Texas. To describe myself in three words, it'll be funny, sweet, and poppin'. G-Kindy Apparel is a positive movement that represents where we're from and how we live.
I could put you in the Mile High Club. What's up? Let's take a trip.
You can follow me on Facebook at Tasia Bonet, Instagram at Tasia Stacks, and Snapchat me at Milkshake.
Tell her be free, baby, spread your wings. Got your legs in the sky like a plane. Let me guide that, I'm the pilot. Can't nobody see you 30,000.
What's up, y'all? My name's Gerald Franklin. I'm from Galveston, Texas. If I can describe myself in three words, it'll be fly shit always. G-County Apparel means everything. It represents the struggle and where I'm from and where I'm at today. You can follow me online on Facebook at Gerald Swag the Fuck Up Franklin, or catch me on Instagram at So Swag Niggas.
Fuck up the lumber, I'm hot like a sauna, yeah. The burner is on me, can't play with that money, yeah. I'm fucking with shorty, I'm loving the way that she fucking me, yeah. Get no fuck off, shit. Yeah.
I got him.
Top of the top. You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and counter.
It's time to get up and count up, man. Get your goddamn stacks up, man. We goddamn me at 10:15. I know y'all up right now. Put a one in the chat if you can hear me, man. Goddamn CEO is in the building. Instagram acting right. My Instagram people in here. Y'all talk to me, man. What's good? Put a one in the chat if you can hear me. Am I clear to you, man? We in this bitch. Y'all know what time it is. They go to sound engineer. K Riz is in the goddamn building. Got him some pickles yesterday. Hey, man, listen. Tomorrow, you want to tune in? Man, I think I got a call yesterday, right? I got a call yesterday about some people who were supposed to be coming over here tomorrow, right, for the show. I got some people that's coming over here tomorrow. Well, no, tomorrow is Thursday. I'm going to let y'all, I don't know if I'm going to let you know. You got to watch the show. Yeah, this is going to be a surprise for my supporters. This is a surprise for the people that watch the show continuously. But you want to tune in tomorrow and Friday. It's going to be a real dope surprise. If y'all liked yesterday's show, Thursday, I got to see. But this shit going to be dope. I got some stuff coming on with the family, and it's not going to be my nephews and them, right? I got some dope stuff lined up. We're going to see if it's going to be tomorrow's show, or we're going to see if it's going to be Friday's show. But I got some very dope coming up. It's the event that's coming up next month, and some people want to come out and film me and my family for a commercial to promote this event. And of course, they want to do it at the time that I'm doing the show. I'm like, hey, I got to do a show. I do a morning show. They like, oh, okay. Well, then I thought about it. Well, no, we could do that, and I could put it on the morning show, and y'all could see that. Y'all going to see something dope. So it may be tomorrow. Right now, it's planned for tomorrow, but I think that's going to change because we're in testing season, and one of my sons got start test tomorrow. So, I mean, both of them got start test tomorrow, so that may change. We may be doing the show on Friday. I got to find out. But I'm going to be able to let y'all know how that go on Friday, right? Yeah, on Friday, I'm going to let y'all know how that go. Yeah, we ain't doing no plan over here, man. We working, and we working all the time. But y'all got to stay tuned in, man. We're going to move on to the next topic. Y'all see the phone ring. People trying to get it on, man. They saying, what's up, CEO? What's good? Let's talk about BG violates his parole, man. That's the next topic, man. BG got violated for his parole. If y'all did not know, the rapper BG from New Orleans, he just served 14 years in federal prison. Yeah, BG just served 14 years in federal prison. He was released, and he got out to a halfway house, right? When you're in a federal system, they have a parole system, parole program that can send you to the halfway house, or you could skip the halfway house by serving your time. Well, BG went to the halfway house to get back accustomed to society. And at the halfway house, he started doing his music. While at the halfway house, and the time they gave him to go out to find a job, his job was as a rapper. He started going to the studio in his time, and he started making music. Well, the music that he made and the music that he produced started generating him funds. Of course, he was a popular rapper when he went in. So when he came out, his popularity was raised even higher. Even as you had other rappers reaching out to him and doing songs with him to make sure he succeed at his profession of rapping. Well, guess what? The parole people did not like that. The parole people took offense to that, and they locked this man up, say he cannot be fraternizing or be working with or around former prisoners. And it's like, what? What? Y'all gonna lock the man up for that? Yes, they locked the man up and violated his parole and put him in jail for working with former people that was in jail and said stop. He cannot be doing that. He cannot be making a living like that, right? And that shit was crazy. So in jail, you know, it was a bunch of uproar. In jail, the nigga is locked up. And again, here we go. The system trying to hold a black man down. Right? That's our narrative. Well, the system holds down any and everybody, man. That's what you got to understand. Once you are in that system, the system wants to control you. There's no bending the rules in your favor. The minute they see you are benefiting from what they have put in place, it's the same minute they're going to take it away from you. This is what I'm telling you. The system is designed for you to not benefit from it. They do not want you to benefit. They want you to suffer. They want you to be punished. They want you to be treated in a manner in which you feel like you are less than a man. They do not want you to think. They want to do the thinking for you. And the minute they see that you a nigga that could think, they want to interrupt your plans and they want to stress you out and they even want to violate you. They violated his parole. He has been in jail now for probably about a week, going through a parole violation over earning income. Now imagine that. They say everybody that's been to jail can't work and be around each other, right? And if you work or you around felons at work, right, you violate your parole. And that mean the whole motherfucking Whataburger going to jail. Everybody at Whataburger on parole. Or goddamn me committed a felon before. The whole Popeyes is going to jail. Half of Walmart got to leave. Half of Walmart got to go. Yeah, these motherfuckers on parole or committed a felon. So what kind of rule is that to even have in place? Oh, well, they say, well, 9 times out of 10, if you are around felons, you and other felons will commit crimes. That's true. But it's different degrees to the felons you're around. If you're around motherfucking felons like me who own their own place and they own their own business, you will get a place of enjoyment, of employment. You will get a job. Felons can help felons. They also can hurt them. But the system does not care about that. See, they don't care about people like me who have went through the system, who have really changed. Because I'm not under their control. They care about the ones they can control. And if they can control you, they have one goal, and that's to break you down. Yeah, that's to break you down. Yeah, to demasculate you, right? This is their whole goal, and this is what they're doing to BG. Luckily, man, he has support. He has a lot of people that's backing him. And even though he's been in there a week, I think they just reinstated his parole. I don't know. Let's kind of read about that and see what they're saying on this matter. But just the mere fact that he got to go through this as a successful artist is ridiculous, man. This shit is ludicrous, man. Y'all can't tell the difference between the people that are robbing, that are getting together to rob, versus the people that are getting together to make money and be successful in life. Y'all, the system can't tell the difference from that. No, they can't. They say BG had permission to perform with Boosie Badass before arrest, his attorneys claim. BG is being accused of violating his probation by associating unnecessarily with convicted felons. What the fuck is unnecessarily? What the fuck you mean unnecessarily? Last month, it was revealed that BG was arrested for alleged probation violation only months after he was released from prison following a 12-year sentence. I said 14. It was a 12-year sentence. Reportedly, the rapper was accused of associating unnecessarily with convicted felons, namely Boosie Badass and Gucci Man. He teamed up with Boosie for a Vegas reunion show in February and joined forces with Gucci Man for a collaborative album, Choppers and Bricks. He was released shortly after his arrest, but could face additional time behind bars in the future. Like, come on, man. According to his attorney, however, he should have never been arrested. In new court documents filed yesterday, April 5th, his team claims that he was given permission to perform with Boosie and asked if he could remain on supervised release instead of going back to jail. BG is scheduled to appear in court on April 8th to address the situation, man. So again, what the fuck is going on, man? What the fuck is going on, man? This system is not built to help us. This system is not in place to our benefit. This system has been designed to destroy whoever is in it and whoever's a part of it. It is no justice there. That's why that bitch blind. Yeah, I don't know. They have a word called justice, and that word is attached to a woman. Justice is a bitch, and the bitch is blind. I don't think y'all know that. Did y'all know justice was a woman? and the bitch is blind. I'm not making this up. The court system has a woman as justice and the bitch is blind. Let me show y'all. Y'all think I'm lying. Y'all think these people ain't got this shit by design. This shit, these people done designed this shit. Yeah, these people done designed this shit here. Yeah. Yeah, the bitch is blind. Yeah, the motherfucker we've been looking for the whole time, justice, is a blind bitch. Yeah, yeah, motherfucker talking about we need to get justice. This bitch is blind. Nigga, what the fuck is we getting justice for? That bitch can't see and the motherfucking scales uneven. Yeah, fuck is we getting that bitch for? We don't need to get justice. We need to get even. Yeah, fuck justice. Get even, Steven. Yeah, nah, don't go get justice. Get even around this bitch. Yeah, we ain't looking for no motherfucking justice. We trying to get even. Yeah, well, matter of fact, fuck justice. Yeah, we need to get even, nigga. We don't want no motherfucking justice. We want even Steven. Yeah, get that motherfucking stick with fire and make this shit foul. Yeah, bring even Steven to the front of the motherfucking courtroom. Don't bring justice up here. Don't bring that bitch up here. That bitch don't know what she doing. That bitch fucking everybody over. Yeah, we don't want that bitch up here. Do not bring justice to the front. Bring even Steven. We want to get even around this motherfucker. We don't want no fucking justice. Keep trying to tell y'all, y'all be doing all that motherfucking march for justice. Yeah, I'm finna show y'all the bitch. The bitch y'all marching by. Yeah. Hold on. This motherfucker won't open up. I'm finna show y'all the bitch y'all marching by. This the bitch y'all asking for. This bitch blind. Yeah, y'all asking for the wrong motherfucker. Get this over here. Don't be asking for justice. Ask for Steven. Even Steven. Yeah, his first name is Even. His last name is Steven. Yeah, that's who the fuck we need to be marching and asking for. Even Steven. Nigga, we need to get even around this motherfucker. Fuck goddamn me justice. This is the bitch justice. Right here. This bitch is blind and her motherfucking scales uneven. Yeah, we asking about the wrong bitch. Yeah, we do not want justice. Take justice back. We do not want this bitch justice. She don't know what's going on. Yeah, this bitch don't know what happened, when it happened, how it happened. That bitch just punishing people. We want even Steven. That is his name. Yeah, when you get on a nigga ass and you hurt a nigga ass, nigga say, all right, man, we even. Yeah, oh, okay, so you know Steven too, right? Yeah, you motherfucking right, we even, bitch ass nigga. We even like a motherfucker. That's who we want. We do not want this bitch here. This bitch here is blind. She is blind, and this bitch can't see, and this bitch fuck over black people for sure. And she fuck over poor people for sure. Do not want justice. You motherfuckers been marching for this bitch. This is not the bitch you want. You want even Steven. That's who the fuck you want. Yeah, bring even to the front of this motherfucker so we can get even. Fuck justice. And that's what BG suffering from, man. It's no justice. The bitch is blind. The bitch can't see what's going on. And the bitch got a tendency to cut off black people's head. You know what I'm saying? The motherfucking scales unbalanced and all that. That is the statue of justice in this country. That is the representation of what justice represents. The bitch is a woman, the bitch is blind, the bitch scales is uneven, and the bitch sword is sharp. Yeah, the bitch got a hell of a sword. That motherfucking sword sharp as a motherfucker. Do not bring that bitch to the front when we got an issue. No, 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 we don't want that bitch. We want that nigga Steven, who first name is Even. That's how we want to get this shit resolved. Because when Steven show up, motherfuckers leave everybody alone. Yeah, when this shit get even, motherfucker go to their corner. I'm gonna go to my corner, you go to your corner, and that's the end of it. But no, we want to march for justice. Ain't no motherfucking justice, man. Ain't happening, man. That bitch is blind, and we shouldn't trust nothing about no motherfucking justice, nigga. We should stand on business every goddamn time and take care of business, man. Because as you see in this BG case, man, justice ain't fair. Lock the nigga up for doing his job. Nigga, you can't be around felons and make what? The whole world has been convicted of a fucking crime. Nigga, the fucking president has been motherfucking me indicted. finna be convicted of a crime. I can't be around the president. Like, come on, man. Cut the whole shit out. Let's be for real, man. This shit is fucked up. The system is not for us. And we don't want no justice. We should have never met that bitch justice. Yeah, nah, we need to meet the nigga, even Steven, so we could goddamn me get some shit straight around this motherfucker, like them jeans when you ironing some shit. Yeah, let's get this motherfucking shit straight. Let's get this shit even. Fuck justice. And, you know, that's my word on that, and that's how I feel. Shout out to BG, homie. Keep doing your thing. I know it's hard out here, and I know it ain't fair, but fuck them. They can't hold you down forever. Keep shooting your motherfucking shot and make them do their motherfucking job, man. That's just what that is, and that's where I'm going to leave that at, right there, man. Yeah, fuck justice, get even, man. That's your boy CEO, man. I'm telling you what time it is, man. Jack Johnson, them bitches.
When whites ran everything, Jack Johnson took orders from no one. While most African Americans struggled merely to survive, Jack Johnson reveled in his riches and his fame. When black Americans were expected to defer to whites, Jack Johnson battered them to the ground. And at a time when the mere suspicion that a black man had flirted with a white woman could cost him his life, Jack Johnson slept with whomever he pleased.
You know what free is, nigga? What's free? Free is when nobody else can tell us what to be. Free is when the TV ain't controlling what we see. Told my n***a I need you. Through all the fame, you know I stay true. Pray my n***a stay free. Made a few mistakes, but this ain't where I wanna be. Before I'm judged by 12, put a 12 on my feet. Told my n***a I need you. Stay up, I know these times ain't true. Real life, what's
just
free?
Just the lad I was cunning, just got a pad out in London.
Wake up!
Top of the dive. You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet, the Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and count up. And count up.
Yo, right back in here, man. Y'all know what time it is, man. We just hit the goddamn hour and 30 minute mark, and we right on time, man. But I got to tell y'all about tonight, man. Tonight we bring y'all something special, something dope, man. Y'all know every day room is dope. Everyday room is lit, man. Tonight we got the homie South Park, J. Rowe. He speaks after 28 years of being incarcerated, man. He came home March 14th. No, he came home March 12th. My cousin came home March 14th. J. Rowe came home March 12th. My cousin did 18 years. J. Rowe did 28 years. So he's following up his interview. What's up, not done yet? He's following up his interview with he following up my cousin interview with J. Rowe interview, man. We want y'all to be in attendance tonight. We want y'all to be in the building, man. It's gonna be another dope show. It's gonna be a good one, man. The whole neighborhood of South Park is coming out to support this brother tonight, to show him love, and he get to tell his story, man, of doing 28 years on a 34-year sentence, man. He get to share with the youth, he get to share with his family, he get to share with his people how he felt and the things that was going through his mind. Again, he just came home, so we bringing him on to the show, man. Y'all know how we do it over here at the Ferguson Chronicles. We always take care of business, and we always show love to our people, man. That's what we're going to be doing tonight, man. I want y'all to tap in at 8 o'clock on my channel, or OG Hollywood channel, man. We're doing Ferguson Chronicles with J. Rowe in the day room. It is open tonight, this Wednesday. We've been doing it on Thursday because I've been doing baseball. But baseball was last night, and then baseball is on Thursday. So tonight we're able to do it Wednesday, 8 p.m. I need everybody in there, man. I want everybody in the building. K-Riz, you still here? Where K-Riz at? K-Riz, you still in the building? Oh, yeah, there you go. K-Riz, you the sound engineer, but I'm leaving it up to you. I need you to go get Miss Mockingbird and Miss Sitting in the Tree. You got to go make this shit right, K-Riz. Yeah, you got to go make this shit right. Yeah, we just can't leave on this note. I can't have people mad at me, K-Riz. We got to make this shit right. I'm sending you on a mission. Miss Mockingbird sent me to get you out of jail. When Dre Too Much put you in jail, she sent me to go get you. I went all the way to Instagram with high, low, and beyond to find you and bring you back from goddamn me banishment. Because nigga had banished you, man. So I need you to go get Ms. Mockingbird and bring her back, man. You got to be the peacemaker. You got to be the peacemaker. You got to be the peacemaker. Yeah, you got to be the peacemaker. Listen, so before I go, I'm going to dedicate this song to goddamn me, Ms. Mockingbird, and I'm going to dedicate this song to Sitting in the Tree. I need y'all, man.
So just in case y'all this didn't know, the government is actually lying to us.
See y'all
and
tonight in
the
goddamn day. Listen.
Garbage, y'all never away from me.
I'll go crazy. Hey.
Oh, baby. Don't leave me, girl. Stay with me, too. Oh, baby. Hey, stay with me, too. Hey,
you got your problem, baby. And I got mine. Let's just
be all about putting it together. Hey, listen.
When you say you love me,
it don't mean nothing. If you care,
you
be here like you used to be. Yeah, listen.
I'm searching for the words to make you realize that I really, really want you to stay.
Oh,
there's a quotation I hold inside, but if you walk away,
you'll make this
romance cry.
Don't
leave.
Hey,
don't leave me, girl. No, no, please
stay with me
tonight.
Don't leave.
Forget my pride, girl.
Forget my problem. I'm begging you. I'm fucked up.
You're my heart. You're my soul. You got
so much control. People be in the ocean and sea. But if you
sail away, you take us in a piece of
day me. Room tonight, man.
Don't leave. No, no, no.
Don't leave me, girl. Stay with me
tonight. Oh, please
don't leave me, girl.
Can't be
stay with me tonight. Hey, I go crazy. Hey, day room tonight, man. 8 p.m. We going up, man. It's all good, man. It's all entertainment, baby. CEO in the building. OG Hollywood, J. Rowe.
No,
no, no, no, don't leave.
Leave.
Hey, don't leave me, girl.
No, 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 please.
Stay with me tonight. Don't leave me, girl.
Can't leave
me.
No, no,
no. Hey,
you take your love away from me. I'll go crazy, crazy, crazy.
You take your love away from me.
I'll go crazy.
I'll go crazy.
If you take your love away,
crazy,
crazy, please stay with me.
Listen, man.
Forever.
Don't take your love away from me, man. It's CEO, man. Listen, it's all good, man. We back in the day room tonight, 8 p.m. Man, it's going up, man. I know y'all be in the building. I know y'all be watching. I appreciate the love. I appreciate the support. Make sure you share this out. This is not no easy thing to do. I know I'm going to piss some people off, but you'd rather be pissed off than pissed on. Apologies to all those that I offend, But I'm always keep it G and I'm always keep it gangster, man. Tonight, day room time, the homie J-Ro, we're going to show love to him and his family. Please be attended. I see y'all tonight, man. Salute from the one and only CEO Hockley. Thanks for giving y'all another day. And I catch y'all back in here tomorrow, man. We'll be right back at it, man. Salute. We out. Happy hump day. Let's get it.
Top of the dive. You are now watching the hottest morning show on the planet. The Rise and Grind Morning Show with CEO Hockley. It's time to get up and count.